When businesses strive to meet the needs of consumers, they oftentimes follow the three pillars of consumerism. One, the consumer needs to have transparency. They need to know that the product is safe to use, functional, and adaptable. Next, the product has to have inspection. The consumer needs to know that the product is moral and functions properly. And finally, the product has to have adaptation. It has to be able to change with the future and change to future times. So, when we look at the three pillars of consumerism, we don't just have to apply it to business models, we can also apply it to the question we have posed today. Should the US halt arms to Saudi Arabia? The answer is a clear and evident no. But to better understand why it's a no, we need to look at it through three points of analysis. First, we analyze transparency. We look at the status quo within Saudi Arabia and the proxy war in Yemen. Next, we're going to look at inspection. And this is where we're going to analyze the strength of the alliance between Saudi Arabia and the United States of America and how it's vital to stability in the region. Finally, we're going to look at adaptation in the future and how the strength of the alliance between Saudi Arabia and the United States of America could indeed lead to domestic reform. So first, we're going to look at transparency and analyze what's going on right now in Saudi Arabia. We look at an article posted by CNN on September 19th of 2019. They talk about how with Saudi Arabia and the proxy war going on in Yemen, there's a lot of bad things going on. And in that civil war, in the proxy war between Saudi Arabia and the Houthi rebels who are backed by Iran, is perpetuating out of proportion than what we saw in recent years. And because of this, we're seeing that Saudi Arabia, while the good guys in this fight, oftentimes their intentions are not executed properly. And the execution of those intentions often leaves those civilians hurt. In fact, an article posted by the New York Times on November 15th of 2018 talks about how in the early parts of November, a Saudi-led airstrike struck a school bus of 53 children aged 8 to 12. And while what I'm saying right now might lead you into the direction to think that halting arms sales is the right way to go, we can still see that the ends will justify the means. In fact, if the US were to pull arms sales out of Saudi Arabia, a bigger and badder nation would step in. In fact, an article by the Washington Post posted on March 14th of 2019 talks about how Saudi Arabia is already in talks of purchasing a new missile defense system from Russia. And if that arms deal were to blow into full proportion, what would happen is that essentially Russia wouldn't hold Saudi Arabia as accountable for human rights violations as the United States does right now. And essentially what we would see is another civil war falling into the hands of Saudi Arabia. So what we've looked at so far is transparency and understood the status quo of what's going on right now in Saudi Arabia. Now we need to look at inspection and analyze how the strength of the alliance could determine the stability within the region of the Middle East. We look at an article posted by the RAND Corporation on February 16th of 2019. They discuss how the stability of the region of the Middle East is completely reliant upon the U.S. relationship with Saudi Arabia. And the relationship is dependent on the arms sales we have going on right now. And how if we want to stabilize the region, bring peace to Yemen and peace to the Middle East, hopefully someday, it's completely reliant upon the relationship between the United States and Saudi Arabia, which is catalyzed through the arms deal. We can see that effectively, the arms deal is a lot more about domestic reform and human rights than it is about legitimizing a trade deficit. And when we look at an article posted by the Cato Institute on December 12th of 2019, they also talk about how if the US were to pull out of the region of Saudi Arabia, it would lead the progressive administration of Bin Salman open to threats in the Middle East, open to the Iranian threats, the Houthi rebels, and threats within the own Saudi government. And we could see reversion back to a civil war that would put Saudi Arabia effectively 100 years back in history. That's not at all what we want. But so far, we've analyzed transparency, we've analyzed inspection, looked at the status quo, and the strength of the alliance. Now we need to look to the future, look toward adaptation, and see how that takes place. So, through adaptation, we can indeed see that through this trade and arms deal, what would happen is more domestic reform within Saudi Arabia. The current administration we see right now in Saudi Arabia is one more progressive than we've ever seen before under Bin Salman and Prince Mohammed. And of course, through this relationship with Saudi Arabia, the US is influencing a lot of soft power through a more democratic nation, a more prosperous and free nation. In fact, in Bin Salman's proposed 2030 vision, he wants to see more socio-economic mobility and better women's rights. In fact, in the past few months alone, we can see in an article posted by the Brookings Institute that women, by royal decree, were finally given the right to drive. And while that seems old and archaic to us in the United States, It's a big, bold move by the government of Saudi Arabia to finally give women more rights within the nation. Not 10 years ago, the nation was still heavily influenced by Sharia law. And now, women are finally given the access to drive and go out in public without being accompanied by a male. And through these increasing human rights and women's rights within Saudi Arabia, we see that this is only can be credited toward the U.S. having heavy influence over the region. In fact, in an article posted by Bloomberg News on October 19th of 2018, they talk about how in the same vision in 2030, Ben Salman said, and quote, he would like to see a nation more tolerant of all religions. This is a quote we never really see from nations like Saudi Arabia, where 10 years ago, they were still heavily influenced by Sharia law. And saying quotes like this could indeed lead to a more progressive nation, with more socially economic mobility, with more freedom, more prosperous nation, and a nation more democratic. So, when analyzing all three points, looking at both the recent historical events, the inspection into the strength of the alliance and how it could provide stability to the region, and how in the future we might be able to use this trade deal as ways to reform a lot of the domestic issues we see within Saudi Arabia, we can see that the ends indeed justify the means, and that when being posed the question today, should the U.S. halt arms to Saudi Arabia, the answer is a clear and evident no.